Bonjour! In this video, you're gonna find out why you can't say ma ami in French. Salut! My name is Rochelle DeMayo, your native French instructor from Belterre Academy. So, you've learned that ma is the feminine way of saying my in French. You know that it precedes any noun that's feminine. Remember, a noun is a person, place, or thing. So you could say ma cousine, ma belle France, ma voiture rouge, and those are all correct. But somehow when you combine it with the word ami, which is friend, like a female friend, and you put ma ami, it's wrong. It's like, what the heck? As a former college professor, I'd constantly hear my students use ma ami, and I'd be like, no, 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 it's actually mon ami. And this is a mistake that we need to learn and work on. So let's dig in a little deeper. As you may know from taking my classes or simply watching my YouTube videos, I'm not gonna get all grammarly on you. I'd rather shortcut the reason to make it easier for you to understand. Basically, ma ami just sounds weird. Apart from the fact that you have two vowels that are right next to each other, vowels being a, e, I, o, u, like a, e, u, I, y, already you know that two vowels sound weird kind of combined like that, but on top of it, they're two A's, and we're not trying to form a liaison sound here. It's not linking anything. So to break that sound, we actually are going to use mon, because it ends with a consonant and it's breaking up that two A's. So now mon ami, where there is at least what you can hear, it breaks it up, but you can still identify the two words without it sounding awkward. You may have guessed it. So this can also apply to other words that start with a vowel and that combination of ma. For instance, if I'm talking about my student Nicole, bonjour Nicole, I could say mon élève Nicole, ou mon intention. Mon intention. Those two words, élève and intention, are both feminine words, just like a lot of words that end in "-tion," but that's beyond the point. And so the fact is, you just separate it so it doesn't sound so awkward, you break it up and it's simply mon élève, even if I'm talking about female, mon intention. So that's it in a nutshell. But I have a last little tip to share. Before I do so, go ahead and click on that subscribe button. Merci. So the last tip that I have is instead of trying to analyze it and get all like crazy about it, which sometimes can prevent students from really learning the language, is simply repeat that three times verbally. Mon ami, mon ami, mon ami, even more. Mon ami, mon ami. And then put the name of a person that you're thinking about, a female friend that you're thinking about. Now use it in a sentence, okay? Mon ami Irma est très gentille. Whatever sentence you want to create with your female friends. Now once you've done that, you're going to switch it up and you're going to say ma meilleure amie, and you're going to finish the sentence describing your best friend, female. Ma meilleure amie. Ma meilleure amie. Sadly, many textbooks don't even remotely teach the structure. And I've had to use these textbooks in college classes and been like, whoa, why aren't they not teaching this? That's actually one of many reasons that I wrote my own two textbooks for learners of the French language. And actually last month, I just published my last little booklet, the shortest booklet I've written. It's simply called How to Teach French Through Community, Games, and Culture. All of the books are linked below and available on Amazon. So, homework for you. In the comment box below, I want you to write down two sentences. One where you're starting it with mon ami and the female name of your friend. You're going to complete that sentence. And then, second sentence in the comment box, ma meilleure amie, and you're going to describe your best friend, also female. Put this in the comment box. I'm interested in reading your sentences. Merci d'avoir regardé la vidéo. À très bientôt, les amis.